I'd like to show you some positioning of yourself, your patient, and to facilitate the techniques of minimally invasive exodontia so you'd be more successful. First and foremost, try to put yourself in a balanced position. We're creatures of habit. We have some old tricks that are hard to break. This is where we contort and do all this and that. So I'm in a standing position where you would be at 10 o'clock position sitting down. So using the PH2, which is a very sharp modified Woodson elevator, let's say I'm approaching tooth number 9 and I use a finger rest. The patient's profoundly numb and I'm verifying that with the instrument, and I'm separating the sulcus attachment. And while I'm also doing that, I'm applying some deliberate apical pressure, and nothing's herky-jerky. Watch my fingers, that's what's herky-jerky. There's no twisting. It's deliberate, slow, steady apical pressure. At times, you might rotate the instrument a couple degrees counterclockwise, a couple degrees clockwise, just to facilitate some movement. When you're done with that step circumferentially, then you have your choice of using one of the Luxator type instruments. This is a Lux 3, and basically it's wider, and I'm applying apical pressure. I'm not using a finger rest, but what you do notice is I'm using my thumb and the pads of my index and middle finger rather than brute force with an elevator like we're taught to pry perpendicular. So then again, I'm circumferentially going around the tooth. I try to avoid the direct labial slash buccal because the bone biotype is pretty thin there. And I'm applying apical pressure and ever so slightly some rotational twist and applying pressure, trying to always remain on the long axis. So let's drop down to mandibular arch. Let's say it's the second premolar. I'm doing the exact same thing. Apical pressure, and yes, you can come from the lingual and be as vertical as you can, and your assistant does not have to contort as well. The next instrument is, well, what tooth am I taking out? So let's say it's tooth number 9 again. So I tend to rotate, have the patient tip their head, and the forceps is like this, and I'm holding it with my fingers and my thumb. And I literally will unscrew the tooth right and left, clockwise, counterclockwise, lefty-loosey, righty-tighty. And then you'll gradually feel the tooth release. The traditional technique is you come across like this, and you're rotating, and your elbow and your shoulder, and you're out there flapping. I call it ODF. And it's just not controlled, and it's not balanced. It's finesse, not force. In the mandibular arch, let's say I'm taking out number 30. I've done the same steps with the PH2, the Luxator. And again, the traditional technique would be to come at this like this. You rotate around and you're doing a figure of eight and buccal lingual. But what I'm trying to teach you is to seat the forceps and gradually just to pump just like that and then rotate it. Slowly rotate it. And you may have to do several cycles of this. And finally, you give the tooth, you'll feel it starting to release. And instead of pulling, look at my fingers and my wrist. I'm literally using my hands and the feel of my fingers to bring this tooth to liver. More often than not, unless it's really tipped, it's going to release to the buccal. And there you have it. Another instrument that comes in handy, and these are the hybrid Luxator periotomes. They're called Luxotomes. This one happens to be an exotome. And the reason I like this is the design of the handle fits perfectly to my tactile senses. It has an indentation right where my finger pads are. All the other companies, they all use the same tips. The handles differ. So you can circumferentially do the same thing. I get user finger rest, but this also comes in handy in a situation where, let's say, tooth number 9 is broken down to the gingiva and it's dense bone and nothing's moving. Well, you can insert this into the PDL space and your assistant's helping you, and then you can use a nylon-tipped mallet and gently tap, tap, and you can seat it, and then you can apply more apical forces, okay? And then, again, I'm not gripping it, I'm not ripping it, it's finesse, not force, and you can loosen it up. Your alternative would be to reflect the flap, remove buccal bone, replace the flap, suture it, and then you have an alveolar defect. So for lower anteriors, again, I would have the patient move, I would adjust the chair, the steps would be the same, and I routinely use the anatomic root forceps. I'm behind the patient, I'm ergonomic, I'm in balance, I'm in control, place this, and literally carefully unscrew, knowing that the roots of a lower incisor are not conical. Anytime I take a mandibular tooth out, if the patient will tolerate a bite block, I do it because we exert tremendous forces upon the TMJ complex. I want to protect that, so the bite block's there. I'm retracting the tissue with my thumb, and I'm supporting the mandible below, and I'm guiding this tooth out. And it's really slow, steady, deliberate forces, not herky-jerky. And then you feel it release, and you say to yourself, self, I'm a lucky guy.